Hello, welcome to my channel, and today's video will be a completely non-sponsored review of St.botanica's Hyaluronic Acid Serum with vitamin C and vitamin E. So let's begin with the review. Hyaluronic serum is a miraculous ingredient that has been proven to reduce fine lines, wrinkles, blemishes, the signs of aging. It adds moisturization to the skin. Many celebrities get it as injections, hyaluronic injections, to appear younger. So when this ingredient is added to a serum or to a moisturizer or even to a toner, then it has been seen that the effects that it has is completely miraculous. So I thought, why not review one of the best hyaluronic serums that is available in the Indian market, which is the St.botanica's Hyaluronic Acid Serum. And so let's see what it is all about. Now, it is said that a hyaluronic acid serum can be used by people of all ages, of all skin types. So is it really true? Let me find out. Now, the St.botanica's Hyaluronic Acid Serum comes in a packaging similar to this, and it is a very sturdy box, not something that is very weak but rather very strong. And when I open it, it comes in a glass bottle, something like this, and with a dropper. So I think the application will be pretty easy. So in case of packaging, I would give it 5 out of 4.5. Just because it's glass, there is always a risk with glass bottles. It is a sturdy bottle, no doubt, but still 4.5. Now let me analyze the ingredients over here. So the first ingredient, which will be obviously the base, it has the maximum amount of it, is purified water. Okay, understandable, because sodium hyaluronate is dissolved in water. Sodium hyaluronate is the salt form of hyaluronic acid, so just to tell you guys. And it has botanical hyaluronic acid, which is the second ingredient, so obviously much importance has been given to the hyaluronic acid serum in case in this serum bottle, so that's great. And next we have vegetable glycerin, very good, because glycerin is a humectant, so it will hold on to water. Hyaluronic acid, it holds 1,000 times its molecular weight in water. So if we stay in a humid place, which is India is a tropical country, so our skin, this is like a magical ingredient for moisturization. And the next ingredient I can see is aloe vera, again very good. Sodium ascorbyl phosphate. Now, what is sodium ascorbyl phosphate? Sodium ascorbyl phosphate is one of the derivatives of vitamin C. Now, vitamin C is usually a very unstable form of it. It's very unstable. Like, whenever we buy vitamin C serums, we see it's a dark bottle. It has to be kept in a cold place, in a dark place, because if it comes in contact with light, it reacts with light and it changes into a yellow color. If your vitamin C serum changes into a yellow color, that means it has reacted. It is no longer good for your skin. Rather, I think it would have some side effects on your skin, because it's no longer in its pristine form, so it's better to throw it away. Now, sodium ascorbyl phosphate is a derivative of vitamin C, which is very stable, so it does not react if it comes into contact with light, it is less irritant. Vitamin C, some people, when they apply it, they say that their skin is very sensitive, or suddenly they feel irritation, they feel a bit of itchiness at the sides. Now, sodium ascorbyl phosphate is very good, because the skin won't itch as much. Rather, it won't itch at all, because I have used sodium ascorbyl phosphate serum and I know that it is actually the best form of vitamin C for people with sensitive skin, people with oily skin. I have sensitive oily skin, so I can vouch for that. St.botanica's hyaluronic acid serum, it has sodium ascorbyl phosphate as a derivative for vitamin C. So again, very good. The ingredients are really good over here. And the next thing that I can see over here is the witch hazel, again very good. And then you have vitamin E, tocopherol acetate, jojoba oil, again very good for skin, and jojoba oil is all that is suitable for oily skin type as well. Green tea, very good, it is famous in Korean skincare regimen. And then your sodium EDTA, sodium benzoate, sodium sorbate, geranium essential oil. So all in all, the ingredients are really good and are of top quality. So for ingredients, I would give it a 5 out of 5. Usually the instructions that come with it say that you should apply it every night after cleaning your face. Apply a few drops of serum to it, massage it into your skin, and voila, you are done. But I would suggest a bit of a change to this regimen. I would say you can use it both the times of the day, at the morning and in the night. Just make sure to use a sunscreen. Clean your face, definitely apply a toner. Apply before applying a moisturizer, apply your vitamin A hyaluronic acid serum, and after applying it, apply your moisturizer, and at the end apply the sunscreen if it's in the morning, and if it's in the night, just do away with the sunscreen. You do not need it. Apply your night cream on top of it, and I think you're done with the skincare regimen. Now the next thing that I would focus on is the price and the quantity. This is a 20 ml bottle, and the price, the MRP printed on over here, is around 1799, which is 1800, but you can get it everywhere at 1500, and if you keep your eye out, then on Amazon and Nika, you can get it for around 1200. At least once I saw it went for around 1000 also, so just keep your eye out if you really want to use this product, and you can get it for around 1000-1200 easy. So now coming on to the overall impression of hyaluronic acid serum for St.botanicas, I would say its packaging is just a teeny weeny bit. I'm a bit concerned about the glass bottle, because while traveling, since it costs so much, I would be a bit worried about it. But when it comes to the ingredients, I applied it for around a month or so, and honestly the first thing that I noticed was the texture of my skin. It improved dramatically, and then obviously my skin turned plumper. Yes, there is a precaution you need to take while applying this, which I have seen many people completely forget to tell the viewers about, or I did not see it even in the website. If you somehow you know that you are going to be in a very dry area, for example in the western parts of the country, or somehow that day you see that the humidity is very low, and there is chances that you will be in a very dry area for a prolonged period of time, I would advise to do away with its usage for that day only, because this hyaluronic molecules, the hyaluronic acid serum molecules, they will be sitting on your skin, alright, and you are applying your moisturizer, but your moisturizer will dry out after some time. So what will happen is, since the hyaluronic acid serum, it won't be able to draw moisture from the air to moisturize your skin, which it actually does, and which is the magic wand of this molecule. In that particular day, it won't be able to draw moisture from the air, from the atmosphere, because the humidity is so low, it's a dry region. So at that point of time, it will draw out moisture from inside the layers of your skin, and it would actually increase the signs of aging instead of decreasing it, if I can say it like that. It's a very complicated process, but at the end you just need to realize that if it's a dry area and you use hyaluronic acid serum on your face, and it's the climate is dry, it will draw out moisture from inside your skin, and rather than having any benefits from it, you will actually suffer from it. So only for those days, just do away with it, or use a very thick moisturizer and constantly reapply it. Just take off your sunscreen, constantly apply your moisturizer, and again apply your sunscreen every 2 hours. That's the only way, and I think you're all done. I think using this product is completely safe. It has no side effects, and it is for all skin types, because I'm an oily skin, I have sensitive skin as well, and I can say all the natural products that have been used over here are completely non-irritant. There is a bit of a slight fragrance, but I did not have any problem with it, so maybe it would differ from person to person. So overall rating would be, if I would recommend it for people to use it, I would say yes. If you want to buy it, then why not, go ahead, try it. It's actually a nice product, but overall my rating would be, it would be 4.5 out of 5. Now this 0.5 the less, it's not just because of the glass bottle, but rather I would say it's the price. I think its price can be easily reduced to around 600 or 700. I'm not saying the ingredients are bad, the ingredients are really good, but sodium ascorbyl phosphate, it is easily available, and the only pricey ingredient over here is the geranium essential oil and the sodium hyaluronic. These two are expensive, so I would say around 600-700. they can make a profit with that amount, with that range. So yeah, 4.5 out of 5. And if you want to buy it, then all the best to you. And if you have liked my video, then please do not forget to click the like button and hit the subscribe button. And after you hit the subscribe button, there will be a bell icon. So just don't forget to hit the bell icon and you will get notification on my future videos. So thank you for watching. Thank you for sharing your valuable time with me and watching this video of mine.